So barite is a mineral made up of barium, which is an element, and sulfate, which is an ion. And sulfate is usually found dissolved in seawater, and barium, we think, comes from breaking down of other minerals, such as feldspars. And those two combine, they like each other a lot, so they get together. You got barium has a positive charge and sulfate has a negative charge, and they combine to make this mineral called barite. And in most modern environments, barite forms on the sea floor as mineral crusts, but in lots of other places, they're found around where hot fluids have circulated into the crust and come up to the surface. And in this case, everywhere we see it, the barite is actually cutting up through the sedimentary deposits or forming these small little crystals just in the subsurface. And so it's a secondary replacement mineral, but it's still an important chemical part of the system here at North Pole. What barite tells us about the chemical system at North Pole is that there was sulfur in the system. And sulfur is one of those elements that very early life seems to have thrived upon, and maybe even evolved from. And so the presence of sulfur in this system, where Earth's earliest record of life is preserved, is important in understanding how life may have gained a foothold on the planet and then changed through time.